Now we are going to discuss a particular condition of collision of two particles in a space. Let us consider two particles. Say one particle is A and the other is B. They are moving, say A is moving with a velocity Va vector and B is moving with a velocity Vb vector. We just extend their lines of motion. So A would be moving on this line and B would be moving on this line. Their lines of motion intersect at point X. The two particles may or may not collide at X depending on their velocities. Or more precisely, we'll say if the time taken by A to reach X and the time taken by B to reach X, if exactly same, then they are going to collide at X. Now we'll analyze this collision in the reference frame of either of these particles, say B. If we calculate velocity of A with respect to B, this is the velocity of A as seen by the particle B. We can simply state velocity of A with respect to B can be given as Va minus Vb. If we vectorially calculate it, this is Va vector, this is Vb vector, so minus Vb vector would be in this direction. This is minus Vb vector, which is exactly opposite to Vb vector. So, the velocity of A with respect to B, we are getting in this direction. If this direction is exactly toward the point B, then we can say A is going to collide B. Or, if we are finding velocity of A with respect to B, it is the velocity of A as seen by B if it is considered at rest. If it is at rest, A is going to collide B only when its relative velocity is directed towards point B. So be careful about this. This relative velocity, when we consider, here we consider B at rest. If this relative velocity has a direction directed towards B, we can simply state A is going to hit B because B we are considering at rest. So, you just write on a note, or it can also be taken as condition of collision for A to hit B. Its relative velocity with respect to B must be directed along line joining A to B. If it is directed along the line joining A to B, that means if B is considered at rest, A appears to be moving directed toward B, so finally A is going to hit B. This is an important condition going to be used in so many cases, you'll see later. Let us take up one more example. It is basically a practical illustration or practical example to understand the concept of collision. Say if this is the earth which moves in its orbit around the sun, and say in the motion of earth around the sun, say there is another comet and this comet is moving towards the earth, or the trajectory of comet also intersects somewhere with the trajectory of earth. And say unfortunately the time at which earth will reach the intersection point at the same time comet is also coming to this point, then there will be a collision which will take place here between the comet and the earth. Now in this situation, what we are drawing, it is very easy to understand. When earth is reaching this point, comet will also reach this point and there will be a collision. In this situation, say earth is moving with a velocity Ve and comet is moving with a velocity Vc. Now, if say some observer is there on earth and who is looking at the comet, we can directly state that this observer will not feel the motion of earth. Like we all are situated on earth and we cannot feel that earth is moving. So, in this situation, if he is continuously looking at the comet, he will feel that velocity of comet will be Vc minus Ve. Or if we find out the velocity of comet relative to earth, in this situation velocity of comet relative to earth will be Vc minus Ve. In this situation, if we calculate it by just drawing the velocity triangle or vector triangle, we can say this is the velocity vc, this is v, so minus v will be in this direction, that is opposite to v, this is say minus v. So direction of velocity of comet which this observer will feel will be this. This is the velocity of comet with respect to earth, which is observed by this observer, and you can see it is directed toward the earth. So actual collision is going to take place somewhere here, but this observer or the people on earth will feel that as it is going to collide on earth, they will feel that comet is directly coming toward the earth and finally it is going to hit the earth. So it is also verifying the analysis which we have just now done, that if two bodies are going to collide, then with respect to one body, the other body must be moving directed towards the first body.